Thank you so much, MJ. I do appreciate it. First, just a quick signal here. I hear my voice. Can you hear my voice down there? Awesome, awesome. Thank you so much for joining us. My name is Jaime D'anna. I am the product marketing manager for New Relic. New Relic is one of the recognized leaders in observability. I don't know if much of you know about observability. We're going to dive into just a little bit on how observability can help you actually streamline, automate, and make your SDLC more intelligent. So with that, let's just jump into it. Safe Harvard statement, obligatory, flash it up there. You don't need to memorize it. We're good, right? Okay. All right, so let's go into the agenda really quickly. I'm going to talk about a day in the life. That which, as a developer, and myself as a former developer, I just touched the mic, I didn't mean to do that, is important to us, right? That which we find painful, and then we'll go into how agentic can resolve many of those pains that we're facing. And then at the end, we'll talk about how we can win together, how we can streamline that software development lifecycle and reduce risk and overall boost productivity, among other many other benefits. So jumping into it, what's the situation on the ground? If I were to tell you 80% of all incidents within any given enterprise are because of one word. But what is that one word? Change. Change is responsible for upwards towards 80% of all incidents. Think about it. You're introducing new code. You're introducing new software, even new hardware in your networking environment, right? These components of change can often cause ripple effects throughout the entirety of your infrastructure. And what that means is you're spending upwards towards 26 to 30% of your time chasing the root cause of that change and then trying to fix it, right? Who wants to do that? Like literally, I didn't, especially if the person before me did not code their, or rather did not comment their code well, so I don't even know what's going on when I step in, right? So change is probably one of the biggest culprits. Now, when this change occurs or an incident occurs, what happens? Well, oftentimes there are very slow manual processes in place in order to ascertain what that root cause is. And this can also, I don't want to say lead to, but it can also encompass lack of visibility. And what I mean by that is if you are contained within a GitHub environment and you see there's a potential incident, you're only getting part of the story, because the other part of the story is that incident's impact on the users, what they're experiencing, right? Which you don't see in GitHub. Or if there are third-party dependencies, there is a software code that has a variable that is calling a specific, let's say, file, image, whatever, from a third party, which is now missing from that database, which is why you're timing out, right? You don't get to see that within GitHub. You're only seeing the actual error. Downtime risk can also come from the fact that you might get one alert thinking that, okay, this alert pertains to this incident that is in place now, but then you start getting 3, 4, 5 alerts. Are they about the same incident? Well, if there's no correlation, all you're seeing is those 5 alerts and there's no way to prioritize them. So noisy alerts can also be the culprit for low productivity when trying to chase that fix. And last but not least, you're trying to enact that deployment without the context of those additional systems that we just talked about, whether they're third-party systems, whether they're additional applications that have dependencies that can hinder the overall fix. You might think you fixed something now, but the same thing will happen in the future unless you have that context. So that being said, a day in the life of somebody who is literally trying to get that the next of software out the door, what are some of the complexities that they face? Well, when you're trying to manage that deployment, you're saying, well, how do I measure the impact of that deployment? If you're just in GitHub as an example, right? How are you looking at what the user will experience once that deployment goes live? How do you make the decision of, well, if I do deploy this and there is an error or 2 or 3, or there is user friction, what do I do next? Do I scramble to fix it, or do I roll back to the previous stable version? And last, but not least, is context switching, right? Again, if you are self-contained within GitHub, that is your world, that is your system of record, what happens when you receive an alert that is tied to another system, such as ServiceNow or any other monitoring system that you have in place? How do you bring it all together? These are common considerations that can hinder productivity. And again, this is all in a manual environment prior to what we saw on Monday, wherein the user is at the command center of DevOps trying to accomplish all of this, dealing with the code changes, dealing with these siloed tools and processes, as well as a very reactive mode of problem solving. So, how do we correct this? How do we streamline this process? Well, again, as you saw on Monday's keynote, when we saw the launch of the GitHub Copilot coding agent, which automates many of the tasks and even fixes for some of the more complex issues that we find within our development environment, that brings us to a high level of automation, but not the full picture. And why am I saying that? Well, again, if we're looking externally, such as the impact to your users, right? What are they doing behind the scenes? Are they rage clicking because they got an error and they don't know what to do? Or are those users just sitting it out, waiting for that page to refresh? Or do they abandon the session? And we all know, 3 seconds, that's your limit, right? If you go beyond those 3 seconds, the users are gone, right? So that's where observability comes in. Now again, New Relic is a recognized leader in observability. And what is observability? It's basically monitoring anything and everything that is leaving off a trace, signal, or log that we can collect in your environment to give you the overall status or health of your digital estate. And if there are issues, not only can we proactively anticipate those issues with predictions, but we can also give you a step-by-step remediation path. Or even better still, now that we have the coding agent, we can automate these fixes without the touch of human intervention. So self-healing is now. It's not something hypothetical. As we saw, we are laying the foundations of self-healing environments. How does this happen? Behind the scenes, again, New Relic is picking up telemetry information from anything and everything that you would like to monitor, whether that's on the application, the infrastructure, the database, user, we call it DEM, digital experience monitoring or management. And what we're doing is we are picking up the information, the telemetry information that tells us how to remediate any incidents or any issues that occur. We tie those to any deployments or any new versions within your GitHub environment. So not only are you looking at the code within GitHub, but you're looking at the code in the context of anything and everything that is related to that application that you are going to reversion, right? And how are we doing it? Again, agentically. So if you are in GitHub and you are using GitHub's Copilot extension, that is your interface by which you can gain all of this automation and intelligence from observability. It is literally the New Relic agent, the New Relic AI agent, speaking to the GitHub Copilot agent, and in this context, the coding agent, and passing that information back and forth, but processing in memory. Why is that important? Because unlike other observability vendors in the market who do not have agentic integration with Microsoft or with any of the hyperscalers, really, what we're saying is if you want to put all of your information within our database, our New Relic DB, which is the largest observability database in existence at this point, you can do so. But if you're locked down and you want to keep all your information within GitHub, you can do that as well. And we will speak to each other via API agent to agent and not necessarily pass any data from one point to the other, but process those points of data so that we can then deliver the response into GitHub Copilot, and that can then affect the fix if necessary. So that's what's happening behind the scenes. It's what we call an orchestration, even though we call it an agentic integration. Integration has kind of a V1 connotation, kind of like a connector, a one-way connector, or possibly bidirectional. But an agentic integration is a pre-built orchestration that has anything and everything that you need to pass the information from one agent to the other, so there's no heavy lift on your part as a developer. It's already done for you. So what this means is, back to that situation on the ground, you get boosted developer productivity. You can anticipate any potential issues, such as this time last year, there was a huge sale that we had today or tomorrow or whenever, and I want to find out if there's going to be any server latency. What should I look out for? You don't have to be in that reactive mode. You can be proactive and look and anticipate any errors that occur. Getting to the root cause analysis quickly, obviously, gives you a much faster mean time to resolution. It means you can solve problems faster, but more importantly, it means you're not spending that 26 to 30% of time that we mentioned at the very beginning chasing bugs, chasing fixes, chasing root cause. You can leave that to this automated closed loop process that we're enacting through the GitHub Copilot coding agent and New Relic AI. So you can focus on that which is important to you: innovation, getting that business critical lead in the market, right? The competitive advantage that everybody's looking for. All right. In the spirit of time, I have a demo for you, but I just want to run through it really quickly. You can find this online, and I'll put the link in the presentation. What we're saying is, again, through the New Relic AI agent, which delivers all of the telemetry or observability intelligence from our agent into, in this circumstance, the GitHub Copilot coding agent, we can deliver the intelligence and the automation, which allows you to maximize your productivity. We're eliminating that risk of downtime, as well as eliminating that risk of manual human-based error. I'm just as guilty as anyone. If you're in GitHub and you're coding, yes, it can tell me if I've missed a bracket or if my syntax is wrong, but it can't tell me, again, if I haven't pointed correctly at, say, a third-party database. It just can't see that far. Also, again, we are providing a closed loop for self-healing, for auto-remediation. So you can find that root cause faster and affect that resolution, that mean time to resolution, shorten that. And you're unlocking everything within a singular UI. In this case, we're just talking about GitHub Copilot. Means you do not have to be observability experts. You do not have to learn our NURCL, which is our SQL-based query language. It's very easy to learn, but you don't have to learn it, because why? Through Copilot, you can query in natural language. Is my latest deployment stable? I just got an alert. Who are the people involved in this team? Who are the relevant team members to resolve this specific error? Those types of queries you can enact through natural language. So I'm just going to jump ahead here. So in closing, again, we're saying with agentic DevOps, we're reducing risk, we're adding predictability, and we are minimizing any potential for downtime. Proactive issue detection, accelerated recovery, automated rollbacks, if necessary, to the previous stable version, and approved efficiency, all through agent-to-agent communication. And I want to stress this again. New Relic, at the moment, is the only observability player that can partner with people like Microsoft, because we're the only ones who have developed this agentic AI capability. How do you get started? Literally, we have a public preview for GitHub Copilot, and we are in limited preview for the coding agent if you would like to participate. It's very easy. Literally, you can go to our website and get started. But again, you do need to have the GitHub Copilot extension, and you need to be a new Relic user. So it is based on named user. That being said, I do want to mention very briefly that we have true consumption pricing, meaning you only pay for what you use. And again, if you're just in GitHub Copilot, that can be your world. No new interface for you. And bottom line is, we want to get you started. Come visit us at booth 518. If you have any questions, we have a blog that is being released tomorrow, as well as a press release with Microsoft. The demo I mentioned will be in the link, and my contact information is here. 5 seconds left. Thank you from the bottom of my heart. I hope you've learned something, and please, let's continue the conversation. Thank you so much.